Hi, Williams.
Hi, good evening.
How are
How
you?
are you? I'm fine.
Nice
You?
to see you. I'm fine. How was your weekend?
Okay, this weekend was very well.
All right, nice. Very good.
It.
Williams, did you work on the platform?
No.
Williams, that's
Really.
not possible.
I had a free weekend this weekend.
Oh my goodness. But you know what, Williams? It's okay though, okay? But I really need you to work on it. And this week, remember that this is the last week, okay? So it's super, super, super mandatory for you and everybody to finish the section four and the final exam. Okay, so please work. Okay, please, 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 because it's the final week.
I will work in.
Okay, thank you. I know you're a good boy.
Yes.
And we missed you on Friday because you were not in class.
Yeah, I work. I came at home at 11 p.m.
Okay, yeah, wow.
Yeah.
All right, but that's good. All right, very good. Oh, look, Elizabeth is here.
Yeah.
Hi, teacher. Good evening.
Hi,
I
Elizabeth.
think
How are
I'm.
you?
Evening.
Yeah, fine. A little tired.
Yeah, I know.
You?
It's well, I'm okay. I'm not so tired today. I guess it's because it's Monday.
And always the Monday is hard day.
Yeah. I guess
Sometimes.
so. Yeah, sometimes. Yeah.
Sometimes.
All right. Very good. All right. Ellie, have you worked on the
Yes.
platform?
Yes, teacher. Today I was working.
All right. Okay. Very good.
But I need complete 3.2, I believe. Yes, 3.2.
Okay.
Only two sentences get a mistake. I write it any way. I write it another way. I got a mistake.
All right, 3.2, you said?
Yes, I believe, teacher. I am not sure, but it's 3.3. This exercise only. You have to make only two sentences.
I can't remember, Ellie. I'm gonna check,
No,
okay? Yeah,
no.
because I don't remember like from all the exercises, but okay. All right, now I was telling Williams, Elizabeth, that this is the last week, all right, of the course, okay? So it is an obligation to finish everything, Elizabeth, by Friday or Saturday morning, okay? So you have to, have to, have to, all right? So remember that section four has to be complete and section and the final exam. All right. So, Ellie, your microphone is off.
Teacher,
Yeah.
I lost my reportment.
Your what?
I lose my reportment.
Ah, but you can say today.
Maybe
Yeah, because yeah,
I
I'm gonna wait for everybody to come to class, I mean a little later, and I will tell you because this week we're not gonna have on Wednesday, we're gonna stay today. For example, we if you want, Elizabeth, when we finish the class, you stay 10 minutes and you finish. And then tomorrow, maybe Williams, if he wants to, all right? And then on Wednesday, for example, I'm just giving an example,
Teacher.
or on Wednesday, another 10 minutes for someone else. So every day, 10 minutes. All right. Hi,
Teacher,
Normita.
but
Hi,
I
Jenny.
need either
Hi,
password
teacher.
is the same.
Excuse
Good
me, Elizabeth.
evening, teacher.
Hi, Jenny. Say it again, Elizabeth.
The password from connecting me is the same, but there is a four. They send me any password.
I don't know what you're talking about. Oh, no, no, today is the same. Today, no, today is going to be the same. I'm not going to finish this one and start a new one. It's the same one. So you only stay, Elizabeth. Okay?
Thank you.
So today is not a new or a different access. It's the same because you stay with me. For example, if you want to stay with me today, Elizabeth, you just tell me and you are the only one with me for 10 minutes. All right? All right. Hi, Oscar. Hi, Ellie, Jennifer, and Normita. Welcome.
Hi, good evening.
Oh, my goodness. Look at this group. It's almost el antiguo que veníamos. Only Oscarito is the new one right now, but only right now, Oscarito. I'm just kidding. I was just looking, was like I had before.
Kid,
right. Yeah, very good. All right. Hi, Jose Luis. Hi, Jenny.
Hi, teacher. Good evening.
Good evening. All right, guys. I just need to give you. Hi, Jose Luis. I need to give you a couple of announcements. Si pueden apagar su micrófono y se encienden sus camaritas para verlos súper bien, así de guapas y guapos, of course. Thank you. All right, very good. Danny, your camera on, please, if you can. All right, guys, I was telling Williams and I was telling Elizabeth that this is the last week of this course, okay?
Okay.
We will finish on Friday. That means, and pero voy a hacer un paréntesis, I want to say thank you to everyone that worked on the platform on section 3. Excellent. Many, many of you finished it, all right? Didn't, but I know you will, all right? Now, it is very, very important. It is mandatory, okay? It's an obligation for you to finish the platform, section 4, and the final exam, all right, for Friday or Saturday morning, all right? Because I have to send the reports on Saturday afternoon, okay? So it's an obligation for you to finish either Friday, it would be the best, okay? Or Saturday, tempranito in the morning, all right? All right, so please, please, please work on that platform, okay? I just want to remind you that you made a commitment not only with yourself, but also with INSAFORP and with the academy and myself, that you are going to complete everything, all the requirements, okay? Including the attendance that you are in the class, all right, and including the platform, okay? Now, this is also like very important, guys, and I know this is the last week, but I have to say it anyway, you have to be in class the 2 hours from 8 to 10, all right? You cannot leave the class because you are tired or because you got bored or because you're sleepy, all right? And you leave the class at 9 o'clock. No, it's 8 to 10, all right? So please this week, stay with me the 2 hours, all right? Because it's important to be here. You have to remember that this is like a beca. This is a scholarship or gifts to you, all right? You can say that you're not paying anything for this, all right? So the only thing that INSAFORP requires from you is your commitment to be here 2 hours, at least the last week of the course, all right? Some of you, I know some of you are always very like in class all the time, all right? And that's very like highly appreciated, all right? But please stay like that the last week, all right? That's with that. Another announcement I have is that remember last previous weeks, we have had, On Wednesday, we had a support session. Oscarito, I don't know if you can put your mic off for a little bit. Thank you, Oscar. That's okay. Thank you. All right. So remember the previous week we have having the sesión de apoyo on Wednesdays after class, all right? This week, because it's the last week, we're not going to stay, or I will not stay on Wednesday. 1 hour. I will stay every day, like today, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, 10 minutes after we finish the class. All right? For example, in case Elizabeth, she wants to stay because she has some questions. So today, Elizabeth will stay. When we say goodnight, everybody will leave, but Elizabeth will stay with me 10 minutes. All right? And then you finish and that's it. Maybe tomorrow, Ellie has a question, and then Ellie stays with me for 10 minutes, all right? That's okay, Oscar. I understand. Me too. All right, so every day, someone can stay for 10 minutes, all right? So usually we finish the class at 10:05, about that, all right? So you can stay with me from 10:05 to 10:15, and you're finished, all right? If you want to repeat tomorrow, perfect. And Wednesday, excellent. All right. So it's okay. All right. But 10 minutes, only one person for one, like per day. All right. For like today, tomorrow, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Okay. And then we finish. Another announcement, guys, that I have, and this is super, super well, que todos son importantes, but this one is also very important, is that on Friday, we finish the course, okay? That is the last day of the course. Now, on Friday, we will have a encuesta de satisfacción or a satisfaction survey, all right? That one, you're gonna receive it on your email and you're going to receive it on your WhatsApp, okay? You can do it when you get it, but I ask you not to do it until Friday with me in class, all right? We will do it together, all right? Because that's better. I'm going to say this in Spanish. I know you understand English anyway. De repente surgen preguntas y como no estoy yo ahí ayudándole, usted se queda así como, ¿y aquí qué tenía que poner? All right? O lo habré hecho bien, okay? Entonces, para evitar eso, el viernes, juntos y juntas, a las 9 de la noche voy a pausar la clase, les voy a pedir que ingresen a la encuesta de satisfacción y todos y todas en el mismo momento la vamos a llenar, ¿verdad? Hay un código, hay un número que a ustedes se les va a proporcionar, de hecho, desde la academia, pero también lo voy a tener yo, por si usted no tiene a la mano. Es el número este, que es la primera pregunta, yo se lo dicto con guiones y todos los plecas y todo lo que va a ir ahí. Y ahí lo vamos apuntando. Luego viene el nombre completo, su correo, todos esos datos son importantes y tiene que ponerlos con el nombre. Por ejemplo, si Oscar se inscribió a este curso como Oscar Armando Bonilla Flores, ese es el nombre completo que Oscar Armando Bonilla Flores debe escribir. Si él se inscribió a este curso con el correo oscarito.bonilla@gmail.com, ese mismo tiene que poner, no puede poner el otro o el que más usa o el que sea no me gusta, no, es el mismo, ¿ok? Y luego la serie de preguntas que le hace obviamente el cuestionario que usted va a contestar, ¿verdad? Al final del cuestionario, es un Google survey, al final dice enviar. Cuando nosotros le vamos a dar enviar, usted lo va a enviar y inmediatamente le aparece una pantalla donde dice el cuestionario enviado. A eso necesito, y se lo estoy diciendo desde ya, y el mañana se lo puede repetir, y el miércoles, y el jueves, y el viernes. A eso necesito que le tome una captura de pantalla, no al cuestionario, no le estoy pidiendo foto de su respuesta, le estoy pidiendo foto de que usted lo envió, ¿verdad? Y esa captura de pantalla usted lo va a enviar ya sea al grupo de WhatsApp que tenemos nosotros o al teléfono que les van a proporcionar el día que le manden la encuesta. Entonces, si yo tomé la captura, y como todas las capturas son iguales, ¿verdad? Porque dice formulario enviado, yo abajo voy a poner Jessica Ivette Cerritos Chacón. Porque quiere decir que yo tomé esa captura y abajito de la captura está mi nombre, ¿verdad? Y así va a ser Norma Araceli Rivera Rivera, José Luis Rivera Gutiérrez, Williams Alexander Rodríguez, etc. ¿All right? Súper importante. Si usted decide hacerlo, no conmigo, a las 9 de la noche, sino antes, pues yo no se lo puedo prohibir. Solo le pido de favor que no se le vaya a olvidar la captura, porque no se puede volver a enviar otro cuestionario. Solo es una vez un llenado de cuestionario, ¿verdad? No se puede volver a enviar. Entonces, si a usted se le olvidó la captura de pantalla, ¡ups!, ¿verdad? Pero ya no podíamos volverlo a llenar, ¿verdad? Porque ya contaría como que Norma lo hizo dos veces, ¿verdad? Entonces, por ejemplo, ¿verdad? Entonces tiene que recordar de cuando le da a enviar y le dice formulario enviado, a eso necesito que le tome captura de pantalla y lo mande a nuestro WhatsApp del grupo o al teléfono que les van a proporcionar el día que le manden la encuesta. Entonces yo les pido de favor que no lo hagan antes, todos y juntas para evitar cualquier inconveniente o cualquier pregunta que les surge en el momento, yo aquí estoy para ayudarles, ¿verdad? Entonces, quiere decir que si usted no ha faltado nunca, pues ese día no va a faltar tampoco, ¿verdad? Y si de repente a veces me ha faltado, ese día no puede faltarme. No puede faltar porque es requisito llenar ese formulario, esa encuesta, porque este es el cierre del módulo. Eso no es que usted esté abriendo, si usted está pensando, por ejemplo, por motivos de trabajo o algo, no continuar y usted dice, ¿para qué la voy a llenar? Es que no es para abrir el siguiente curso, es para cerrar este, ¿verdad? Entonces, sí necesito que el viernes usted puntualito y puntualita a las 8 de la noche esté conmigo, pero a las 9, no voy a decir, ah, pues me meto hasta las 9, nada, usted tiene que estar de 8 a 10 conmigo, ¿verdad? Entonces, a las 9 sí vamos a hacer el formulario, el cuestionario juntos, vamos a hacer una pausa y vamos a hacerlo juntos. Entonces, sí, el viernes, Williams, yo sé que el viernes es bien complicado para usted por motivos de trabajo, pero este viernes es como que no puede faltar, Williams, ¿ok? Así que Pinky promise que usted va a estar en clase, ¿verdad? Y los demás igual, ¿verdad? Que siempre están, se les pide de favor que tienen que estar ese día y ayudarnos a llenar esa encuesta, ¿verdad? Que obviamente no solo le ayuda a usted como participante, ayuda a la institución, tanto a INSAFOR como nosotros como academia y a mi persona, obviamente, ¿verdad? Que soy la que estoy directamente con ustedes acá. Entonces, eso va a ser el viernes. Para los niños y niñas que entraron más tarde, son varios puntos, ¿verdad? Pero uno es el llenado de plataforma, y se lo puede decir en español, es de rigor y obligatorio terminarme todo, incluyendo la sección 4 y el examen final. Viernes sería lo ideal en la noche, pero si usted no puede, es sábado temprano de la mañana, porque ese día yo voy a estar mandando reportes, ¿verdad? Entonces recuerde que es el compromiso de no solo estar en clase, pero sino también hacerlo de la plataforma. La otra información que les acabo de dar a los compañeros es: este miércoles no nos vamos a quedar hasta las, yo no me voy a quedar hasta las 11, ¿verdad? Sino que lo vamos a dividir. Hoy, por ejemplo, me voy a quedar, generalmente terminamos clase 10 y 5. De 10 y 5 a 10 y cuarto, yo me voy a quedar to help para ver si, por ejemplo, Elizabeth me decía, teacher, yo no me he podido entrar. Entonces, hoy Elizabeth podría quedarse, ¿verdad? O mañana si Henry tiene alguna duda, igual se queda 10 minutos después y así todos los días, ¿verdad? Eso sería. Entonces hablamos del llenado, de la encuesta de satisfacción, del terminar la plataforma, que es obligatorio, ¿verdad? El estar conmigo por lo menos esta última semana de 8 a 10, que es el horario de su clase. El horario de su clase es de las 8 y media a 10, no es de 9 a 10, no es de 9 y 45 a 10, o no es de 8 a 9, no, es de 8 a 10, ¿verdad? Entonces son esas reglas y esas cuestiones que son importantes seguir para que usted no se vea afectado o afectada en un futuro que usted quiera tomar otro tipo de curso que INSAFOR les puede apoyar, ¿verdad? Entonces sí es como de rigor que usted esté aquí, al menos terminemos esta semana así bien juiciositos and very nice, like very nice children, all right, from May to 12. From May to 12, ya le aumenté dos, from May to 10. Ya me emocioné yo. All right, so, entonces esos niños, yo sé que tenía que tomarme estos minutos para explicarles eso, y todos los días les voy a recordar, viernes es el día de la encuesta de satisfacción, es necesito que estén en clase, ¿verdad? Para llenarlo juntos. Yo les pido de favor que mejor se esperen al viernes, lo llenamos juntos por cualquier duda. Y no se nos olvide la captura de pantalla, que eso es súper, súper importante. De enviado, ¿verdad? No de sus respuestas, es de enviado. All right, guys, very good. Thank you. Do you have any questions about what I just said? Questions, questions, questions. No questions. All right. Henrito, enciéndame esa cámara, lo queremos ver. Ya es la última semana, ¿se imagina? All right, excellent, Henry. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Hi, Dianita. Very good, Diana. Welcome to class. All right, guys. Very nice. So I'm very glad to have everybody with me again. This is like the very last week of everything. I know that it's been difficult, all right, because it's time that you have spent here with us. But it's for you, all right, for your own good. And I hope you have learned a little bit, all right, or at least you have practiced your English a little bit more. So, guys, we are going to talk today about another generation. This time we're not really going to talk about millennials. We're going to talk about Gen X. Yeah, my generation. I'm so excited. All right, so we're talking about Norma's generation, Oscar's generation, Jennifer's generation, and my generation. All right, so I'm going to show you that I'm going to begin the class by showing you the manual of the book that we use. And I want you to work on some of the questions, all right, that I'm going to present to you. Right after that, we're going to come back. We're going to discuss the questions. Then we're going to do some reading. And then we're going to answer other questions. And then that's how we're going to be playing today, reading and discussing and stuff, all right? Remind me for Diana and Silvia later on, maybe like after I take attendance, so I can tell Diana and Silvia the anuncios that I just gave like at the beginning of the class, okay? So Diana and Silvia también están en la misma página que todos y que todas. All right, so this is what I'm going to show you right now, guys. How many people I have so far? 3, 6, 9, 11. All right, let's see. So this is what I have. Let me see here. All right. So, guys, we're going to begin Unit 4. All right. And it's called The Generation Gap at the Workplace. All right. So, we just finished last week. We were talking about leading millennials. All right. So, here are the millennials. And we talk about stereotypes, their characteristics. All right. We talk about advantages of having millennials at work. We talked about tips to guide or to lead millennials and stuff. So that's what we talked about last Friday. Now, today we're going to begin, Unit 4, the generation gap at the workplace, all right? So what are you going to be able to do? You're going to be able to compare the assets, employees that belong to the X generation and the Y or millennial bring about to the workplace, all right? So what I want you to do is I want you to take a picture of this questions right now. Number one, it says, let's start. Are your co-workers part of your generation? Number two, is management in your workplace exercised mostly by people who belong to the X generation or to the baby boomer generation? How easy is it for you to interact with co-workers with other generations? Do you consider that if two people belong to different generations, they are very likely to have conflicts due to the differences in their values and beliefs? Why or why not? So please take a picture of this right now, all right? So you guys can go to your groups and start discussing, all right? Think about, I mean, talk about it. So if I'm working, for example, with Jenny, then I'll say, okay, Jenny, are your coworkers part of your generation? I know, and I can ask Jenny, for example, are you a millennial, Jenny, or are you a Gen X? And she says, no, I'm a Gen X. Okay, so are your coworkers part of your generation or from different generations? And then Jenny's going to give me her answer and she's going to ask me, what about you, Jessica? And I will give her the answer, all right? And then the next question and the next question back and forth, all right? Did you take a picture of these guys? Yes? Yeah?
Yeah, we did it.
Excellent. All right, very good. Thank you. All right.
Yes, really.
Thank you. Excellent. Oh, hi, Nubia. Guillermo, my goodness, it's Monday, huh? Very nice. Nice to have you in class, Guillermo and Nubia too. Very good. All right. I don't know, Guillermo, were you, Guillermo and Nubia, were you able to take a picture of what I just presented? Yeah?
Yes, teacher.
All right, very good. Okay, so let's go to our groups right now, guys. All right. And then I start discussing and talking about those questions. Then we're coming back. We're discussing in a general group. Then I'll give you some definitions. All right. And then we'll talk about it. All right. To our breakout rooms. So we have this. There we go. Hi, Ellie. Hi, Ellie. Ellie? Hi, Williams.
I know what happens.
Huh?
I don't know what happens.
It kicked you out?
Yeah.
Hmm. All right, I'm gonna move
in. I was with Jose Luis first and next with Yesenia.
Uh-huh.
But I don't know what happened.
I think Yesenia just, she might be having problems with her internet. Hold on.
Okay.
All right, Williams. Where are you, Williamsito? No lo veo, Williams.
First with Jose Luis and next with Yesenia.
Yeah, I know, but I don't even see your name right now.
Okay.
Oh no. Okay.
I am out of the group.
No, you're not. I don't know what happened. You were here. I saw you, but now I don't know. Williams, it takes you a long time to get out and to come in again.
I left the group.
All right.
Okay.
Hold on. Let me see. Hold on.
Okay, no problem.
They belong to the X generation. But no, the baby boomers, no.
Oscar.
We don't have any baby boomer.
Oscar, can you hear me?
Now, loud and clear, Silvia.
Oh, okay.
Tell me, are your co-workers part of your generation?
Repeat, please.
Are your co-workers part of your generation?
Oh, yes. There are many co-workers part of my generation. Yeah. Very young. What is the other generation after millennials?
last class, I saw there was the young, the oldest millennials and the newest millennials.
No, but after, but is the Gen Z? The Z.
What?
La generación Z.
Okay, Z.
I have a coworker of generación Z.
Really? Wow. Very young.
Very young, yes.
Oh my goodness.
They are in informatics and robotics.
Ah, oh my goodness.
Mm-hmm. They are very, very young.
I see. Okay, like, and you have...
Like 18, no, 17, 18 years old.
So it's like their first job, Silvita.
Yes, yes, they are very, very smart.
Of course, yeah. They're more techie than millennials, I guess.
Yes. Is management in your workplace exercised mostly by people who belong to the X generation?
I don't understand.
Williams, ¿qué hace aquí, Williams?
No, I...
¿Y no le sale la invitación, Williams?
No.
Ya se la mandé dos veces.
No aparece.
A ver, lo muevo ahorita otra vez.
Ok.
Mire ahorita.
No.
Williams, is there something wrong with your phone or your computer?
What happens? And really... Maybe if I leave what the session, then I come again.
Yes, that would be a good idea. Yeah, please do.
Okay.
Thank you. All right, Williams, let's see. Try now.
Yeah. Oh, now.
Excellent.
Thanks.
Yeah, yeah.
You are absolutely amazing.
Aha, Dianita, what happened with Jesse today? Jesse's a rebel, I know.
Yes. What happened, Jesse?
Tell me, Diana.
I'm talking about the generation.
Yeah.
She was telling me that she sometimes doesn't wear the veil. I don't know how to say it. The veil. The veil. And I think that's amazing.
Wow, Jessie. Look at her.
She asked me about my coworker are using Facebook. And I told him, my coworker use Facebook. And one day I shared with them one picture of me, but don't use my heavy dress. And they are very scattered because they see me a different way.
Uh-huh.
That is the reason that Diana are very smile.
She's laughing. Oh.
Yes, and that's okay. I have to get that, I don't know.
Take off?
That picture. Take off the picture because all my coworkers are very scattered. And I don't have another way that take off the picture of my Facebook.
Is Jesse, is the same picture that I saw the other day? No.
It's other picture.
Oh, look at her.
That's amazing.
Jesse.
Yeah.
Now, yes. Jesse, do you always have to wear it? Is it mandatory? Yes. Do you always have to wear it?
Yes, it's a mandatory use my uniform all time.
Okay.
Only for a sleep. Yes.
Right, of course.
But in another moment, I have to use all.
Even
time
when you are, even when you are making sports, right? Like playing basketball.
I always have to use. I playing. I teaching the class. I take some meals. All time I have to use my heavy dress. But in some moments are very boring. I don't want to wear in that kind of dress. And I put another dress and I take my picture because my family like, I like to see a different way.
All right.
That's the reason. But only
yeah, she's totally my millennial.
Yes, she's a millennial.
Only my girlfriend, not outside.
So wow.
That's amazing.
Yeah. I'm millennial. I don't have the boring with that I the other sisters.
Right.
She see the life in another way. I see the life in another way too.
All right.
The students tell me you are different, mother. You are free, you are friendly, you are humble. And I tell, yes, I am another generation.
That's amazing.
My goodness, you are terrible, my friend.
Yes, I am very terrible.
Look at her. Oh, my goodness. Oh, no. All right. That's interesting. All right. Let's see. Diana, Jenny, what happened to Jenny?
I don't know.
All right. Okay. So, girls, have you been talking about which question are you answering right now?
Number one.
Okay. Yes. And Diana's like number one. Very serious. Yeah, I like that. Very nice.
So
okay,
let's discuss the
number one. Are your co-workers part of your generation?
Is management in your workplace exercise mostly by people who belong to the X generation or to the baby boomer generation? In my case, my father, I think it's like the ultimate manager in my business. Mm-hmm. And he's a baby boomer.
Yeah, he's a baby boomer, right? Mm-hmm. All right. What about in your case, Jessie? Okay.
In my case, is a baby boomer too, because she has 63 years old.
She is. All right.
She's 63.
Right, years old. Yeah. Baby boomer. Okay, interesting.
Next one.
Yes. Next one, Jesus.
Yes, because I don't want to continue working about my principal today. Because today she did me. You continue. You being the next principal in the institution. You have to work a lot of. I don't know, I don't be the principal.
You don't want to be.
No.
Jesse, but you could change the way people see things.
Yes. Yeah, but I was principal in the last years, and I don't like be the principal because you don't have the with the people's. You have direct contract with the papers, with the Minel, with another institution, and that I don't like for me. Like to play with the babies. I like to carry on the babies in my hand. I am a more phobial people that I don't like the principal.
All right, okay. She's so interesting,
She's great. You're so great, Jesse,
how old are you?
33 years old.
Okay. That's amazing. Okay, how easy is it for you to interact with coworkers from other generations? Okay, in my case, it's easy for me because I respect them. But for the way that they work, I think that's important. And for the way they think, I think it's important to respect them.
Right.
Okay. In my case, mm-hmm. Easy, because I had a good relationship with all my coworkers. In some moments, not as easy because by my photos behind or don't like for some people, but I can't pay attention for the bad things. Mm-hmm. All my coworkers, during my that they are thinking about me, the most important is to listen to them, talking with them, and when they see that I don't pay attention for the bad things, they change their mind. Mm-hmm. And it's so easy for me to interact with all day.
We believe you, Jesse.
Yes.
Yeah, but they are very boring. I tell some joke because I like to. They are very
friendly and happy.
Very smiley, very friendly, very happy. Yes, and that's it. And some moment I go with them for some places for see a movie. Oh. And I like to that because they that kind of activity has more friendly with the people.
All right.
That's great.
Very good. Yeah, interesting.
That kind of activities help you to build.
Yes, for example, that Avengers is a good.
Oh my
it's a good movie to see.
Jesse.
Jesse, what? I see with my co-workers, see that movie in the cinema, and make it very friendly for the co-worker because they thinking that it's bad to see that kind of movies in my case. But I broke all the rules.
Yeah, you do.
So did you go to the movies with your habit?
She went to the
see
movies.
The Avengers. Oh my!
Yes, just in my habit rest.
That's amazing.
Cool.
Because in my school, the sisters were telling all the time that all the movies were like from the devil, the devil.
The evil, yeah, the evil.
The devil.
Yeah,
yes, but in my case, I think difference.
She's a millennial, Diana.
A millennial sister, yeah. I think that's amazing.
Yes, I like to see the movies because all the young peoples mm-hmm. are more friendly when you know about the topic they are talking.
Yes,
for example, yes. That's Korean groups. I don't like that group because they're gay for me.
But you have to talk about them with your children because they love them. Like
yes, them. But I have to listen their music. I yes. have to know about them
because you have to
my
connect with them.
Love uh-huh. them
with your right. students,
and yeah. I have to have a connecting mind with my students for understand them.
That's right.
And for give some bills too, they have to improve in the life.
All right.
That's the reason.
My goodness, Jesse, you really inspire me here.
That's amazing.
That's nice.
Because
but it makes sense. You know what? It makes sense what she's saying because sometimes we forget that we need to connect with students or with children, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. So it's not a matter of about she liking it or not. It's a matter of finding a way to connect yes. to the students that she works with, right?
Yes, and the student like to you be more free to make the things because in 1 year, I was teach class for the children of 6 year old, mm-hmm. and I sit down in the, I don't know, in la tierra. I sit down mm-hmm. here and I play with the children. And the other teacher that had the section B don't like that because don't like the dresses. And the children tell me, I want you are my teacher because my teacher don't play with me. Okay, come with me. You can play with me. And all the people want to play with me. And they tell me that I be the teacher of day because I am playing with them. I am junior say I eat with day too because I eat in the moment that I eat two meals in that year.
What?
Because you I eat with my sisters and I eat with my students too.
What?
Yes, but that is the thing that you connect with the people, and in that moment you can know the actually reality of the people, because in that moment is when the people have the best behavior of their life. I think
that's interesting because I never it's amazing for me because I've never seen in my school eating a sister with anybody because they were eating inside I don't know in their homes.
Right.
I never seen
I play them. Football, I play basketball, I what? Dance with my students. Yes, I make all that. I have picture about
I can imagine
that sky for security.
Because when you are doing that those stuff, everybody is like, let's take a picture. Because it's playing.
Right.
Playing basketball.
No kidding.
Yes.
That's cool. All right, very good.
That's really cool.
Yes, and the making that connection with that generation, when the another coworker see that you are very jovial people, mm-hmm. they make the same, and they try to improve that kind of tratar, I don't know.
Right.
To the children.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And they be more young people can tell you, because they tell me, you give me energy and can be yes. the same with you are.
Mm-hmm.
And that is very good in one institution, one business, because mm-hmm. you can help for the another generation.
Mm-hmm.
Be and go on for education too, for making that you are using or you are making too.
Yes, that's amazing. Yes, because your job is to build a new generation, to teach a new generation. So it has a lot of meaning, a deep meaning.
Deeper meaning, yeah.
And deeper meaning.
Yes.
Yeah. Girls, we're going to go back right now so we can discuss the questions, all right?
Okay. Thank you, teacher.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, guys, we're back. All right, so let's discuss these questions together. Are your coworkers part of your generation? Okay, let's see, guys, here. Just tell me if they are or not, all right? So, Norma, in your case, are your coworkers part of your generation? Yes or no, or some?
What to repeat, teacher?
Yeah, I was asking if your coworkers are part of your generation.
They have a mixed teacher.
Okay. All right. Okay. I understand. What about?
We have a few boomerang co-workers that mostly is for X generation.
Okay.
Then have a Y generation, Z, mm-hmm. and millennials.
All right. Okay, I see. Very good. Okay, what about Williams in your workplace? Williams, do you have like different generations at your workplace?
Almost are like my generation.
Okay, all right. Yeah. All right, cool. Very good. Silvita, in your case, Silvia?
Yes, there are many, many co-workers from my generation. We have baby boomers, and we have Generation Z.
Yeah, Generation Z. All right. Okay. The last generation right now. All right. Very good. Yes. Well, what about Guillermo? Hi, Guillermo. In your workplace, Guillermo, do you have, are there like different generations at the workplace?
Yes, teacher. Generation X.
All right. And do you have millennials also at your work or not?
Yes.
All right. Okay. Very good. Henry, what about in your case?
In my case, teacher, I have most generation, millennial generation, but I have the different generation too.
Okay. Very good. All right. Jose Luis, in your case? Jose Luis, can you hear me? All right, Jesse, what about in your case, Jesse? Are like the same generations or different generations?
Are different generations.
Okay.
In my institution are Generation X and baby boomers too.
All right, okay, very good. Vero, thank you, Jesse. What about Vero?
Good evening. In my company, there are the majority people are X generation.
Oh, hey, cool. All right, very good. Ellie, what about in your case, Ellie?
In my case, I have coworkers, mostly millennials.
All right.
But I have coworkers, baby boomers, and X Gen X.
Oh, cool. All right, very good. Diana, in your case? Janita, are you there? All right, Oscar, what about in your case, Oscar?
Maybe the 85% are uh-huh. millennials. Okay. 85%.
Okay.
Young millennials.
All right.
From the extremes, the youngest.
Okay.
Millennials and the oldest millennials.
All right. Okay. Uh-huh. All right.
And
what about the rest?
The rest we are
X generation. Okay. All right, very nice.
Maybe
all right.
15%.
All right, I see. All right, very good. What about Moises? Moises, can you hear me? Yeah.
Yes, good evening, teacher.
Good evening.
And the majority we are millennials.
All right, okay. Nubia, what about in your workplace?
In my case, they are millennials.
Okay, all right, okay. All right, very good. And Elizabeth Salguero, what about in your case?
Teacher, the company that I work, we have to mix generation.
Okay.
Because the owner,
uh-huh.
the management is younger.
Oh, okay.
But the owner, teacher, they are baby women.
Oh, all
because teacher, only the owner, the company, mm-hmm. she's 93 years old.
She's not a baby boomer. She's a generation before baby boomer.
Yeah. I'm thinking about it.
Uh-huh. Right. Okay.
Yes, but the owner, she has a different life because mm-hmm. she's working, she's swimming, she's doing.
Okay.
Swimming, she's driving.
Wow.
But the generation and this the company is mixed.
Okay.
Mixed. Generation right. Y, Generation X.
Okay, I see. All right, very good. All right, very good. Thank you, Elizabeth. Very interesting. 93, wow. All right, I wish. All right, yes, okay. What about the second one, guys? Is management in your workplace exercised mostly by people who belong to the Generation X? Or who is leading the company? Generation X people, baby boomers, or millennials? Anybody in your companies, who's leading or who's managing the companies? From which generation?
In my case, teacher, the manager are X generation.
Okay.
Only one manager had less than 30 years.
Okay. All right.
One wow. 13.
Okay. Okay. All right. Very good. What about Oscar in your company? Or like X generation.
X generation right. and the baby boomers are already Julie.
Ah, they're retired.
They retired already, but they were troublemakers.
Oh my goodness. All right. Okay. Very good. Yeah. Interesting. Williams, in your company, who's leading the company or who's managing the company? Which generation?
It's Generation X.
Okay. Very good. Yeah. All right. Silvita?
Millennials.
Elizabeth, in your case, millennials. All right. Silvia, what about in your case? Silvia, in your company, who's managing or leading the company? Which generation?
The managing is a baby boomer.
Oh, okay. All right. Okay, very good. Benito, in your case?
In my case, only one, I forgot the word.
Manager? No?
Yes, only one manager is millennial. Okay. The rest are X generations.
X generations, all right, yes. Very good. Eli, Larin, what about in your schools? What is the generation leading or managing the school?
In my case, is Generation X.
Okay.
It's generation teacher.
All right, yes. Very good. All right. Okay. Diana, in your case? Dianita's not around. Oh, there he is.
Yes. In my case, is my father who is a baby boomer.
All right. Okay. But it's also you, right, Diana?
Yes, it's also me. Yes.
All right, so a baby boomer and a millennial. Interesting. All right, very good. Okay, Guillermo, in your company, who's managing the company? Which generation?
Millennial teacher.
Oh, okay. All right, very good. Okay. All right, what about in the company of Moises, Henry, and Jose Luis?
Generation X.
Okay. All right. Okay, very good. Nubia, in your case?
Baby boomer generation.
Mm-hmm. All right, interesting. All right, well, I'm going to keep on asking the questions, guys, but I need to take attendance right now. Nancy Elizabeth Larin Chavez. Nancyita Eli.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Erika Lirio Perez Diaz. Thank you, Eli. Yes. Erika Lirio Perez Diaz.
Okay.
All right. Eric Mauricio Pérez Hernandez. Nope. Henry Vladimir del Citepas. Henrito.
Present.
Thank you. Jose Luis Rivera Gutierrez.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Moises Eduardo Alas Roque.
Present.
Thank you. Oscar Armando Bonilla Flores.
Present.
Thank you. Cruz Yesenia Maldonado Tejada.
Present.
Diana Gabriela Hernández Morales.
Present.
Andrea María Trabanino Alfaro. All right, Williams Alexander Rodríguez Argueta.
Present.
Thank you. Francisca Irene Lima Hernández. Hey, what happened to Irene today? All right, Guillermo Antonio Amaya Escobar.
Hi, teacher.
Hello. Jennifer Carolina Bonilla. Gerardo Daniel Gómez Rodríguez. Gerardo's not in. Norma Araceli Rivera Rivera.
Present, teacher.
Elizabeth del Carmen Salguero Romero.
Present, teacher.
Silvia Marisol Villalta Martínez.
Present.
Thank you. Verónica Lizeth Soto Serna.
Present.
All right, Nubia Araceli Cortez Amaya. Nubia Araceli? Well, she's there with us anyway. All right, girls and guys, I just wanna remind you because some of you came in a little later for Diana, for Guillermo, for Nubia. I thought, well, no, maybe she was here already. For Silvita and Vero, at the beginning, I gave some announcements, all right, some things that I really, really need you to pay attention to, all right. I'm sorry for the ones that ya lo oyeron, pero lo van a volver a escuchar. Son anuncios muy importantes que tengo que compartir con ustedes, all right. Jennifer, entró otra vez. Excellent. Thank you, Jenny. Esta semana es la última semana de este curso del avanzado 1, ¿verdad? Entonces, sí es de rigor que ustedes estén, bueno, siempre ha sido de rigor, que ustedes estén en la clase de 8 de la noche a 10 de la noche. Ese es el horario que usted, al cual está inscrito y el cual debe de respetar de 8 a 10. Pues no podemos ya hacer nada por las semanas que ya pasaron, pero sí les pido que esta semana, por favor, estén en su clase de 8 a 10 de la noche. Es importante, es de rigor y es obligatorio que ustedes me terminen y trabajen en la plataforma. Esta semana es la última, entonces viernes sería lo ideal. Terminando la sección 4, más el examen final. No es solo la sección 4, es toda la sección 4 y el examen final. Yo sé que Guillermo ya la completó, ¿verdad, Guillermo? Que yo vi que sí. Estaba todo. Súper, Guillermo, excelente. Sí. Se lo agradezco de verdad. Y los demás, ¿verdad? No sé, Silvia, ¿cómo va? Porque todavía el sábado que revisé estaba, no estaba.
Ya estoy al día, ya estoy al día.
Ok, perfecto.
Hasta la 3, ya creo que solo la 4.
Hasta las, ok, perfecto. Sí, porque el sábado que revisé todavía estábamos ahí, pero si usted me dice ya voy a revisar igual para ponerle eso al día,
solo tengo unos ejercicios que tengo dudas, pero yo le escribo.
Bueno, chivísimo, aquí estamos para servirle. Entonces sí, para todos y todas, el viernes sería ideal que usted me termine todos los ejercicios de la sección 4, incluyendo su examen final. Eso es para al final de la semana, ¿verdad? Que sí necesitamos terminar eso. La otra cosa es que todos los días de esta semana yo me voy a estar quedando 10 minutos más después de cuando termine la clase para su sesión de apoyo, ¿verdad? Que si, por ejemplo, alguien o Oscar, por ejemplo, hoy tiene una duda de algo, quiere comentar algo, practicar 10 minutos más, Oscar se queda de 10 y 5, digamos que terminamos la clase, de 10 y 5 a 10 y cuarto, mañana Normita, si gusta, y el tercer día Guillermo, el cuarto día Verónica, etcétera, ¿verdad? Solo serían 10 minutos, no un solo día como teníamos anteriormente, porque esta es la última semana. Entonces, eso, ¿verdad? Y luego el viernes, como es el último día del módulo, vamos a tener algo que se llama la encuesta de satisfacción. Entonces, eso es para cerrar el módulo, no para abrir el siguiente, ¿verdad? Es para darle el fin al módulo como se debe. Esta encuesta se le va a hacer llegar a usted tanto por correo electrónico, a su correo obviamente, y por vía de WhatsApp. Entonces, a su WhatsApp, ¿verdad? Va a llevar hasta así Diana Gabriela, ¿verdad? El nombre del estudiante, del participante. Usted lo puede hacer, puede llenar la encuesta el día que la reciba. Sin embargo, yo le estoy pidiendo de favor que se espere al viernes, ¿verdad? Que la vamos a hacer juntos y juntas para que si en caso surge alguna pregunta, pues estoy yo en el momento para solventarle la duda, ¿verdad? Entonces, si usted es de las personas que dice, ay no, yo la lleno ya mejor, pues hágala, ¿verdad? No hay ningún problema. Solo que le pedimos de favor que cuando usted termine de llenar su encuesta, que no es muy larga, y le da a enviar, cuando le dé a enviar, necesito que tome una captura de esa imagen donde dice formulario enviado y lo mande al WhatsApp de nosotros, al del grupo o al número de teléfono que le van a mandar cuando le manden el vínculo de esta encuesta con su nombre, para que las personas que lo reciban sepan que esa toma de captura fue de Oscar Armando Bonilla Flores, ¿verdad? Porque todas las capturas son iguales. Entonces, para distinguir quién la mandó, entonces la captura y su nombre abajo, ¿verdad? La encuesta de satisfacción es de carácter obligatorio. No es que, mire, yo no quiero llenarla. Es que no se trata que no la quiera llenar. Es que tiene que llenarla porque es parte de todo el proceso, del requisito que se pide, ¿verdad? Y como le digo, es del cierre. Eso le da el cierre al curso, al módulo. Entonces sí es como muy importante, yo sé que los que están aquí pues siempre son los que están acá, ¿verdad? En clase, y este viernes, si nunca ha faltado, pues no se le ocurra faltar el viernes aunque sea el último día de clase, ¿verdad? De repente uno dice, ay, el último día, yo no voy a llegar, o no voy a llegar, no voy a estar conectada, ¿verdad? Ya no llegamos porque estamos en línea, pero le pido de favor que ese viernes sea al contrario, ese día usted diga, para nada voy a faltar. Sí es muy importante que usted realice esa encuesta de satisfacción, ¿verdad? Que nos ayuda a todos y a todas a seguir mejorando el proceso de calidad, ¿verdad? Para que se le ofrece a usted, ¿verdad? Entonces sí es como muy importante que usted sea parte de ese mismo proceso, que al final usted es el beneficiado. Entonces sí necesito eso para el viernes, el terminar la plataforma y luego lo que se puedan quedar o quieran quedarse o tengan alguna duda o alguna inquietud o solo quieren practicar un poco más los 10 minutos cada día, ¿verdad? De esa semana. All right. So, eso quería decirles para los compañeros que entraron después. Así es que de favor les pido esta semana, sí, de a las 8 de la noche en punto, usted se conecta y luego pues termina la clase hasta el final, ¿verdad? Así es que se lo agradezco de verdad. All right. Y los, por las que la gente que lo han hecho, pues yo se lo agradezco siempre. Son así como súper, súper puntuales y todo lo demás. Así es que, thank you guys. All right. Y ya pasamos 5 semanas. Súper rápido, siento yo. Hemos así como que ha volado el tiempo, ¿verdad? Ya pasó 1 mes y esta semana pues sería la 5ª. All right, guys. So let's continue. No sé si tienen alguna duda, inquietud o algo para esta de lo que acabo de comentar. ¿No? ¿Estamos bien?
No, teacher.
Excelente. Very good. Entonces, sí, sea, no coma ansias y hagamos la encuesta juntos el viernes. All right? All right. So let's continue here, guys. Very good. So we have here this one. The other question was, how easy is it for you to interact with coworkers from other generations? All right? This is for anybody that wants to answer. Do you guys, en otras palabras, do you guys get along with everybody, no matter which generation everybody belongs to, or you have difficulties getting along with different generations? Anybody? Uh-huh.
I don't have problems.
You don't have problems, William?
Yes, independently what generation is. Okay. I have problems, yeah.
All right. Okay, I believe you. You're always smiling. All right, very good. All right, very good. Anybody else?
What, teacher?
All right, Normita, Jose Luis, and then Jenny. Excellent. I like it when you guys part of the pelea. Excellent.
Okay.
Normita.
In my case, had a few issues with the baby boomerangs.
Oh.
Because the technological gap between there and us.
Okay.
With here, and that person had a difficult to learn.
Okay.
And nowadays, all the reports, the capacitation or training or presentation using the technological tools.
All right.
In many cases, have a disadvantage because okay. We need to prepare a double material.
Mm.
One specific for this person and another for the old. All the other generation, because we need to all understand better the topic.
All right.
We put in practice that situation. All only right. That.
All right. Very good. Anybody else? Ah, no. It was Jose Luis and then Jenny. Uh-huh.
Okay, in my case, teacher, I don't have any problem. And I like to work with people of different generation. Because when they are older, sometimes they have a different behavior. Mm-hmm. And I have advantage because they can give me some advice.
Okay.
And for millennial for work, it's good too because they are more knowledge about technology. It
okay.
Doesn't matter. Work with anybody.
All right. Okay. All right. Very good. All right, Jenny, what were you going to say, Jenny?
Yes, teacher. Sometimes, yes, like Norma is difficult to try to the baby boomers.
Uh-huh.
Because they have a specific thinking and sometimes don't understand the explanation.
Mm.
Sometimes. And okay. With the millennials, it's easier to try to them.
Okay.
Yes. The attitude is different.
Right.
And
right.
The knowledge is different. And
right.
And the understanding is different too.
All right. Okay.
Yes.
All right. Okay.
Yes.
All right.
Learning easier.
Right. Okay. Okay. Very nice.
Yes.
Thank you, Jenny. Anybody else? Do you guys get along with different generations or you have problems with different generations?
Teacher, sometimes, yes, I have problems, but I continue with the generation.
Uh-huh.
I think it's the attitude of the person because
okay.
Every person is more open and sometimes more
okay.
Serious, maybe.
All right. Okay. Okay. I guess it has to do with that too. Very good. Anybody else? Oscarito, in your case, Oscar.
I get along with anybody.
Okay.
Yeah, we only have millennials and next generation now.
All right, that's good.
We're okay. Yeah.
Okay.
At the working place.
All right, Vero.
In my case, it's easy. I haven't never problems with the other people who belongs to the other generation.
Okay. All right. All right. Very good. And Jesse. Hi, Jesse.
I remember. Okay, in my case, it's so easy to communicate with all the generations. Yes, the baby boomers have different ways to think the things.
Okay.
But when you are talking with them, you can help to go on your generation and make the thing that you are using or you okay. are making. But so thinking different, but for me though, how trust in the communication, I okay. have good relationship with all my co-workers.
All right.
And all that are very important because the baby boomer had more experiences
okay.
than I have. And that's good for me because I learn a lot about them.
Right. Okay. You learn a lot from them. All right. Irene. Hi, Irene. Nice to have you in class, Irene. I was wondering where you were. Hi.
Sorry, Irene. Teacher.
That's okay. Thank you.
I salí very, very noche de trabajo.
Oh, my goodness. All right. Very good. All right. Interesting. All right. So, yeah.
All
right, yeah. Okay, let's see the other question here, guys. Do you consider that if two people belong to different generations, they are very likely to have conflicts due to their different values, guys? Have you ever, not you, but for some other people, do you find it difficult for other people to get along with other generations? Or do you have never experienced that in your job places?
Teacher.
Yes, Willie. Guillermo.
In the group, I send my experience
mm-hmm.
in this moment, and in my case, this year the manager changed.
Okay.
I have 20 years ago it was a baby boomer generation, the manager.
Okay.
In this year, mm-hmm. changed for millennial.
Okay. Oh.
It's been difficult, but mm-hmm. the baby boomer is a very experienced.
Mm-hmm.
The millennial say that the process is wiki.
Okay. All right.
But not the experience is okay. for my case.
Okay. All right. Interesting. But what do you like better, Guillermo? I put you
for
on the spot.
For the experience, baby boomer.
Okay.
Because the leadership, the guy in the for the process.
Okay.
The millennial is only decir.
Say
the order.
Uh huh.
Is weekly.
Okay.
Well,
okay.
In my case.
Right. Okay. All right.
No respect the process.
All right. Okay. Interesting. Okay. Very good. What about the rest of you guys? Have you like
okay.
Jesse?
I think in the bill of values are the same, but the belief are different.
Values are the same, but beliefs are different. Okay, I get it. Okay.
Yes, because the baby boomers, the baby boomers are outdated people.
Yes. All right.
I think in that.
Okay.
Because all the things they see bad. Mm. All your photos be they see bad.
Okay.
You have to be quiet. You have to be thinking another way.
Okay.
Yes, that is the belief that they have that a grown see that goal.
All right. Okay.
And the beliefs are the same because all time you have to be humid, you have to be responsible, you have to be make the things very well.
Okay.
I think that's only the belief.
All right.
It's all very, very different.
All right.
Because all generation see life in different ways.
Okay. All right. All right, I get it. Okay, interesting. Anybody else?
Me, teacher.
Yes, Danny.
I think that people may have differences between them, mm-hmm. but not based on the generation.
Okay.
But in the way that in which they are.
Okay.
Because if they have like different values or different beliefs, it depends if the people or if the person has the tolerance or if they have the will to comprehend the other the other people.
Okay. So interesting. All right,
that's what I think.
Mm-hmm. Okay, very good. Anybody else?
Well, teacher, we had a different for to learn and to teach them.
Yeah.
But when the company have the values as an organization, mm-hmm. we don't have a problem.
Okay.
Because all the generation need to accomplish the values for the company. No matter is a baby boomer or millennial.
Okay.
All that need to accomplish that values it try to practice.
Okay.
And when that situation are agree for all, no a issue.
All right. Okay. All right. Very nice. Interesting. See, that's why I like to share those questions because all of you have different opinions, but at the end it's like pretty much the same. All right. I'm gonna my mouse is getting crazy, guys. All right. I want you to do this. If you have your booklet or your manual or your book with you, you don't have to take a picture. In case you don't, I want you to take a picture of baby boomers, Gen X, Gen Y, and bridge the gap. All right. Now, what we're going to do, I'm going to send you again to your groups and I want you to discuss what baby boomers are. What do you know about baby boomers? All right. But don't Google it, okay? Because Googling is easy. What do you know about Gen X, Gen Y, and bridge the gap? What does that mean? All right. Now, what I want you guys to think is baby boomers in El Salvador, Generation X in El Salvador, Generation Y or millennials, which is the same in El Salvador, and bridge the gap here in El Salvador. All right. Because a lot of reading and stuff, and I'm going to share a reading for you or with you. But it's, of course, from the States, all right? But what I want you to think, okay, so what are baby boomers here in El Salvador? What do I know about them? What is the year range of baby boomers, all right? The same thing about Generation X. You can talk about characteristics. You can talk about stereotypes of the generations. Tell me what you think about them. And I just want you to come up with, you know, like a topic to discuss with your classmates within the groups. When we come back, I'm going to share the definitions, the right definitions to say it somehow about each of the ones that I just mentioned, all right? So baby boomers, Generation X, Gen Y, and bridge the gap, all right? Those four things, all right? So let's go back and let's talk about it. Hi, Ellie. Elita. Hi, Eli.
Me salí porque el inter me sacó.
Ah, vaya, ahorita, Eli, espéreme, denme just a little bit.
Okay.
¿Te acuerdas con quién estaba trabajando, Eli?
Con Nubia.
Ah, okay. Ahorita.
Gracias.
Thank you.
What can I say? I don't know what was happening at that time.
The baby boomers, they are responsible of the war in El Salvador. I don't know that. I don't know many things of the baby boomers. I have a doubt because the war, I don't know so much about the civil war of El Salvador. I studied in when I was studying, but I don't remember a lot of things. But I think there are part of that conflict, maybe.
The baby boomers. That's a lot of things that we can. After the World War II, there was the split between the capitalists and the communists. There were two parties around the world.
Cold War.
The Cold War. Okay. Wow.
Cold War. Guerra Fría.
You are well documented.
I study history. I know a lot of things of the war. But it's strange because the history of country, I don't know so much. I don't like to.
Okay.
I don't like to.
The Cold War, these baby boomers are really, they feel hard. I mean, they feel the Cold War. They identify, they have, they are like, very sensible. It's a sensible topic for them.
I read that the civil war from to El Salvador was one thing that caused was the Cold War. Because they are a conflict between communists and
capitalism.
Capitalism, right.
Capitalism. Okay. Actually they weren't they were the head, not the how to say the los comandantes, the commandants, how to say that. The older they wanted the leaders in the civil war, they were baby boomers actually.
Yes.
And the fighters were X generation. The fighter is X generation. Wow, I'm sorry. But I didn't know that. And
but I guess they were the earlier, like the generation X, Oscar.
Mm-hmm.
because Generation X begins like about 1967, about that.
Ah, 67.
Mm-hmm. About that, yeah. So by the time, like, it was the real conflict, I mean, the conflict began back in 1932 in El Salvador, but it wasn't really known until the 1980s. That's why people say that we only had 12 years of civil war, began way much, like, earlier than that.
But I thought...
So the Gen X, I guess, they were like about 15, 18 years old. The some of the people that were already fighting, but I guess baby boomers are the ones that, I mean, it's not that they began it, but they were fighting.
The baby boomers, we were talking that they were the leaders, and the X generation were the fighters.
I guess, most in of a way, them. Yeah. I guess both of them, right? Like Gen X, like the earlier Gen X, because I know I am a Gen X, but by the time, like, it was 1980, I was 1 year old, all right? So I couldn't have fought, all right? But for example, one of my oldest sisters, she was born 1969. So by the time it was 1980, we can say she was like 11. And we all know that many children were already at the war, all right? So like they were very, very young.
That's how the
So we're talking about 11, 14 years old. So maybe some of them are already fighting.
Yeah. And how about the Y generation?
The Y generation is as the millennials.
Is?
It is. It's the same. Some people call it like...
New millennials.
Yeah. The nickname for the generation Y is millennials.
Oh, they are. Okay.
But it's the same generation.
I'm sorry. Okay.
Yeah.
So millennials.
X and Y is the same. No.
No, the Y and millennials is the same. Like the legal name, Silvita, is Gen Y, Generation Y. But because they were like really close to the new millennial, that's why they are called millennials. All right. But it's the same generation. And after that, like after the 2000s, is the Generation Z. All right, from like 2000 to like some people say up to now, or like now there is a like another Alpha generation or something like that. It's from the 2013 to 2025, about that. But it's still like, you know, like those are not like so yet stated as like the other generations. They're still thinking. That's like those are the generations to come.
Wow, I see.
So it's interesting because
the youngest, we don't know so much about baby boomers. The youngest, the millennials, we know more like old generation, like millennials. No, another.
Right.
That is important to know because we are part of one. I think my parents are baby boomers.
Right.
Baby boomers, and we have to understand them. I have to know about his kind of thing, the thoughts or values.
Right. How they were raised, what they stuff. Yeah.
Wow, it's interesting because I didn't realize.
Yeah.
Sylvia told me, and it's true that the X generation was influenced by the Cold War.
Right.
They are very we are somehow very polar. It's not my case.
Right. But
the X generation tends to be so polarized. And few agreements.
Right. And it's true.
It's in El Salvador, it was about the Cold War. In millennials from the 80s on the thousands, 2010, they knew few about the war. They were growing up. They were growing up and they missed a lot of information.
Right.
They don't think it's useful information.
Yeah, which is wrong because it's part and it's part of their history.
Okay,
And it has made them the way we are because of that.
Uh-huh,
we work we have baby boomers. My boss is baby boomers.
Okay.
We have a lot of fun because they talk about, there are, do you hear about viejo agogo? Mm-hmm. Viejo agogo. They told me that the viejo agogo is a baby boomers, but within the youngest. There are more technological than others, like new music, funny moments, and dancing, and they are not boring, kind of boring. Right. They are they talk about viejo agogo, and they are they tell us that they are
right.
Very, very interesting because right. We work very good with youngest.
Okay.
Youngest.
We also, I want to say that technologically talking,
mm-hmm.
Speaking of the information, IT, the information technology, we were in El Salvador somehow behind it.
Oh, yeah.
In the timeline, we were behind. So for me, the baby boomers, the X generation,
mm-hmm.
are like an underdevelopment generations.
Of course.
We are getting the technology, many years before.
That's right.
That was brand new. But in the case of the millennials, they got it almost at the same time around the world.
Mm-hmm.
Around the world, well, they got the information technology at the same time.
Yeah, you're right. Uh-huh. Yes. Yeah, we got it behind. One of the points that also Jesse mentioned the other day is like, depending where you grew up,
uh-huh.
It also made a difference because it's not the same thing as growing up in the city, the growing up in the countryside.
Of course.
All right. So especially in our type of countries, right? Like underdeveloped countries, because we don't get, you know, even now it's not the same to get, you know, like a phone here in the city than a phone in, I don't know, like a canton from I don't know where.
Uh-huh. You know, we were so susceptible. I mean, for fake news.
Right.
To say something because
it's
the only word that I have now. But we were so susceptible for fake news. But millennials are not. They are.
Right.
They dig. They search. They right. know on time. They're on live. No, maybe live. But
yeah,
they got the access.
Right.
They got access to any information around the world and at the same time.
At the same time, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Teacher,
yes.
In my for example, the owner of my company
mm-hmm.
is a baby boomer.
Okay.
But he's a person really updated.
Okay.
Yes, because he's very smart. He's entrepreneur.
Mm.
He always is learning for new technological
right technology. Mm-hmm.
Yes, yes. Right. And my boss is X generation.
Okay.
Yes. And all he right. too is a data person.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think it has to, this is like what I've been saying, Verito. I think it doesn't really have to do with what type of generation or which generation you belong to, but it also has to do with the attitude, all right? Yes. That your personality, the way you want to keep on behaving, because there are like millennials, just because you're a millennial doesn't mean that you have to be tech savvy, for example.
Yes.
All right. I know people that are older and they are super tech savvy. All right. They know a lot and maybe they are like even older than me. All right. But they know their way around computers and they are very, very savvy on those kind of topics. All right. So sometimes that's why they are stereotypes, you know, because some people think, oh, everybody should know about it if you're a millennial, for example. Not necessarily. Or you shouldn't know about this because you don't belong to this generation. But why? I mean, I think everything, the way
you the way you think, the way you behave, the way you want to do things, the place where you actually are at, because it's not the same. I don't think a millennial is the same thing here in El Salvador that in the States than in China, for example. It's very different. I mean, it can be a millennial the same year, they were born the same year, but of course technology is different here in the States and in China or Japan. Can you imagine someone from those countries? I mean, they're even more tech savvy than someone from here, I would believe, because they have access to everything. They make things over there.
Yes, because in China, the child start learning technology.
Since kindergarten.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, you know that we are getting closer and closer to be at the same time. They're only going to be a matter of money, as the teacher said. It depends on the on your economic situation. Mm-hmm. I mean, if you have money, you will get the technology, the smartphone, right. The things. Now we are closer to that, but in the 80s, even if someone had money in El Salvador, didn't get the newest.
The newest equipment.
No, you had.
No, I mean, yeah, we were getting it later.
But yeah. But I think they changed, the millennials changed, as you say, from China to the U.S. or in Latin America, But they behave, they change because of their values and their culture.
Right. That's right.
But the technologically, we are almost, almost at the same level to access information.
Right.
Access,
yeah.
We have to make clear that we're talking only information, technology information.
Okay. All right. I see. Interesting. All right, guys, we're going to go back right now because I want to share the reading, okay?
Okay.
Thank you.
Veronica? Hi, Veronica.
Hello? All right, guys, I'm going to take attendance again right now because I just saw one. Because it's time to do it. All right, let's see. Is everybody back?
Yes.
All right, Nancy Elizabeth Larin Chavez. Uy, oigo eco. Nancy Elizabeth Larin Chavez.
Present, teacher.
Erika Lirio Perez Diaz.
Present.
Hi, Eric. Eric Mauricio Paredes Hernandez.
Right.
No. Henry Vladimir Del Cid Tepas.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. José Luis Rivera Gutiérrez.
Present.
Moisés Eduardo Alas Roque.
Present.
Thank you. Oscar Antonia Flores.
Present.
Cruz Yesenia Maldonado Tejada.
Present.
Diana Gabriela Hernández Morales.
Present.
Andrea María Trabanino Alfaro. Williams Alexander Rodríguez Argueta.
Present.
Francisca Irene Lima Hernández.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. All right, very good. Guillermo Antonio Amaya Escobar.
Guillermo,
he was here.
There is.
Jennifer Carolina Costa Bonilla.
Present, teacher.
Gerardo Daniel Gómez Rodríguez. No. Norma Araceli Rivera Rivera.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Elizabeth del Carmen Salguero Romero.
Present.
Silvia Marisol Villalta Martínez.
Present.
Verónica Lizeth Soto Serna.
Present, teacher.
Ann Nubia Araceli Cortés Amaya.
Teacher.
Oh my goodness, very good. Thank you. All right, guys. So, Gen A, I mean, it was baby boomers, the first one, right? Was it?
Yes,
yeah, baby. Okay, baby boomers. What do we know about it? What can you tell me about baby boomers, guys? Anybody?
Baby
boomers. Dianita, then Jennifer, and I think it was Oscar after. Diana, go ahead.
that was the generation after, right after the World War II.
Okay.
That's it.
Okay, thank you. Very good. Thank you, Diana. Jennifer?
Yes, they were born in between 1946 to 1964.
Oh, excellent, yes. Jenny. Wow, you have studied. Excellent. Very good. Anybody else with baby boomers? Anything else about baby boomers? What do we know about them?
Well, teacher, we define with the group the characteristic.
Okay.
They was responsible.
They were responsible. Okay.
Like it, hard worker.
Okay.
And commitment and highest ethical values.
Oh, all right. Interesting. All right.
And then for by behavior, they are respectful.
Okay.
Formal dressing.
Yeah.
Puntual, based on the experience more than theoretical.
Oh, all right, nice, Normita. Who are you working with, Norma?
I working with Jennifer.
Uh-huh.
No. And I'm sorry for the other co-worker. I don't
classmate.
No, it's a.
Who was working with Normita?
Ellie and Jose Luis.
Oh,
Jose
it was Luis, four of you guys. All right. Okay. All right. Also, they were two Gen X and two millennials. Interesting. All right. Very good. Thank you. All right. Anybody else about baby boomers? No?
They are loyalty employees.
Oh, all right. Okay. Interesting. All right. Very good. All right, what about Gen X? Guys, millennials, what do you know about my generation?
I am Gen X.
Uh-huh. So what can we say about Gen X? What do we know about them? Come on, don't be shy, millennials. Tell us about
Gen X.
Uh-huh.
Yes, the Gen X was born between 1965 to 1980.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they were the beginners to the new technologies.
True.
The new business.
Right.
New ideas.
Right.
In the world.
Okay. Very good. All right. Anything else? Thank you, Jennifer. Wow, Jennifer, you have studied. All right. Very good. Anybody else with Gen X? Come on, Oscar, say something about our generation.
I think that this was the first generation in which the values or the view of the family was changed.
Okay.
Because the baby boomers, they have this vision, this classic view of the family.
Okay.
In which the man was working and
right.
The woman
was staying at home.
Okay. Yes, and the Gen X was the first generation in which the woman start working.
Right.
And
okay.
They have a different view.
All right.
The family.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Interesting. Very good. Okay. Okay. Anybody else?
Lisa.
Yes, Irene. And then Oscarito.
Oscar.
Oscar is a gentleman teacher.
I know.
No, we were talking with Silvia and Veronica that the X generation in El Salvador was influenced by the Cold War. And it's a polarized generation. And that's it. What can I say?
All right. Interesting. Yeah. All right. Very good. Irene, thank you, Oscar. Irene, what were you going to say about my generation? About Gen X.
Teacher, my report is very short, but I think this generation, Generation X, is a group very suffer.
Ah.
Because
I'm going to cry.
like the wars in El Salvador.
Right.
Then for that, I think that this group is very, very suffer, and consequence is very, very efficient. It's very, very hard, very
hardworking, of course.
Uh-huh.
All right.
I have this concept.
Okay, very good, Irene. Nice, very good. Anybody else? Say something good about my generation, okay?
Okay, I give some characteristic about the Generation X. They are independent people.
Of course.
Because they start to working with independence. And in the case of the women, don't depend for their esposo, I don't know.
Their husbands.
Yeah, they have the husband, they are yes. Very yes. Independent sometimes, people.
Sometimes a little rebel, yes. Like a Yesenia.
All right.
No, I don't agree with you.
Jesse is a millennial.
Yeah. Yeah.
Another characteristic is the work-life balance. They balance the work with the life with the family life.
Okay.
And tell them.
All right.
And they are flexible too.
Okay.
And had a good characteristic because are informal in some cases.
Okay.
And that characteristic held to the young with the millennial generations.
All right.
Because the millennials in some cases are informal too.
Oh my goodness.
And
okay.
That's it, the mixing or the young, the two generations.
Okay, I see.
And in that generation, the start to using the technology and start to using that indeed that the business all the kind of technology but in millennials are developed the technology
okay all right okay
technology start in the
Gen X.
Woo-hoo, yes.
Very good.
We are the beginners.
That's right, yeah. Very good. All right, guys, I want to show you this quickly here because of time and everything, but I thought it was, well, you know what? Before that, I just want to show you this. This is a chart of generations, all right, just for you to know. There's the first generation, let's say, generation, all right, it began from the 1890s to 1915, all right? Then after that is the interbellum generation, the greatest generation from the 1910 to 1924. After is the silent generation, and then is the baby boomers, all right? So I guess our grandparents or great-grandparents, they are from the silent generation, all right? The baby boomers generation, then is us, Generation X, then is millennials. Or Generation Y, and then Gen Z and Gen Alpha. These two, they are like, let's say that they are not so stated yet as the other generations, but this is just a general information that I found for you, all right? Now, let me show you here. This is Generation X, all right? A lot of like the rock and roll or a lot of like new bands and everything came out, all right? Just like you guys mentioned, technology, developing on Generation X, all right? We were the first one to play Atari and Nintendo and Betamax and those things that Oscar made a point that we got it later. We in El Salvador as Generation X, we got it later, all right? While in the States, for example, they were getting the technology that was at that time, they were getting it earlier. We were getting it later. And if you had money, you got it earlier than people that did not have money, all right? So. Then we have what have we witnessed as the Generation X, the end of the Cold War in general, like about the world, but us as like Salvadorians, we, as Irene mentioned, we lived the civil war here in the country, all right? So we were part of it. Some of us were younger, some of us were older, but we were there, all right? We were children of the war, all right? AIDS, that became in the 1980s about that, a little earlier than that. The 1990s, like the bill, like all these bands of music and everything came out, all right? Some of the characteristics of Gen X, it says is a notable feature of Gen X is its high level of education, all right? Due to this generation's lack of faith in employee commitment, Gen X is convinced, hold on, I can't see. real job security lies in their ability to develop the knowledge and the skills to advance to, to their next job. First and foremost, they're individuals when asked. Most do not view themselves as part of group generation. It's not like millennials. They are very like teamwork kind of people, all right? Us, we're like, it says that it's like more like individually. Gen X has no distinct defining characteristics. If you need to classify them as something, try a multicultural version of Breakfast Club, a small band of diverse individuals that do not live anywhere, not even with themselves, all right? They were the first generation to brought up in an instant gratification society full of microwaves, ATMs. See, this is the beginning of technology here. Microwaves, ATMs, remote controls, all right? I remember that I did not have a remote control when I was growing up, all right? But after that, I saw them. I was still young when I saw them. Gen X has the mentality of what's in it for me, all right? Like, I'm gonna do it, but if there's something in it for me. They are cynical about the commitment between employers and employees since they watch their parents and grandparents lose their jobs after years of dedicated service. All right, Gen X values work-life balance. This is what Jesse was saying. They want their careers to be exciting as well as enjoyable, but they also expect to have plenty of time for their families, all right? So this is like roughly what Gen X is about. And then I have this quickly here for you. We have like about 5 minutes, guys, quickly. I know. Here it says, people grow older, birthdays are the same. Hold on. All right, baby boomers. The baby boomers were born between 1946, as Jennifer said, and 1964, 1966, about that. They are currently between 56 and 74 years old. All right, Gen X was born between 1965 and 1980. All right, and currently they are currently between 40 and 55 years old. Gen Y, or millennials, were born between the 1980s, 1994, 1996, or some theories also tell you to like all the way to 2000s. They are currently between 24 to 39 years old. All right, remember last time we saw this video that it was like, well, it was two generations, like not in millennials, we have the early gen millennials and the later millennials, all right? So the Gen Y.1, they are between 25 and 29 years old, and Gen Y.2, they are between 29 and 39. The Gen Y.2 are the oldest millennials, all right? Los que nacieron en los 80s, 81, 82, all right? The other ones, they were like in the 1990s, all right? Then we have Gen Z, is the newest generation to be named, and were born between 1996 and 2015. All right, they are currently between 5 years old, oh, my daughter, and 24 years old, all right? So they're like about that age. Let me see something that I wanted to show you here, guys. We're not gonna read everything. I just wanted to show you this one. Again, baby boomers, 1946 to 1964, they're between 54 years old. Baby boomers are the biggest consumers of traditional media like television, radio, magazines, and newspaper. Despite being so traditional, 90% of baby boomers have a Facebook account. Cool. This generation has begun to adopt more technology in order to stay in touch with family members and reconnect with old friends, all right? So even though they are older, but some of them, they are using technology to keep in touch with everybody, all right? Shaping events post World War II, optimism, the Cold War, and the hippie movement, all right? Finances, managing retirement with life expectancies on the rise, all right? Let me see. Yeah, this is what I just read to you. Generation X, Gen X birth years, 1965, 1979, current age, 40 to 50. The media consumption, Gen X still reads newspaper, magazines, listens to the radio, and watches TV, about 165 hours worth of TV a month, wow. However, they are also digitally savvy, yeah, we know a little bit, and spend roughly 7 hours a week on Facebook. I don't have Facebook. The highest of any generational cohort, or a cohort is a group. Let me see. The shaping events, end of Cold War, in our cases, the end of the war, all right? Well, no, the beginning of the war, pretty much, the middle of the war. The rise of personal computer, I'm feeling lost between the two huge generations, all right? So we're between the baby boomers and the millennials, all right? So this is like, oh my goodness, all right? All right, it says the Gen X is trying to raise a family, pay off a student debt, and take care of aging parents. This demands a high strain on their resources. The average Gen Xer carries, these are numbers from the States, they are not gonna like be ours, all right? Then you have the millennials, that this is the generation we have been talking about, all right? So, but the one I wanted to like show you were the baby boomers, that we just read it, and the Generation X. All right. Why am I showing you this? It's because for the rest of the week, we're going to keep on talking about comparing generations to see what can we get from like all generations. Because remember that we, and you guys said it perfectly well, we can learn from all generations. All right. We need to be open-minded no matter what generation we belong to. All right. But it's really important for us to keep, you know, our minds open because we can always learn from the past generation and the generation that is after ours, all right? So, and we're gonna be talking about how everybody or how generations deal with the different job positions and workplaces that we belong to, all right? So guys, I'm gonna stop class right here. I don't know if Elizabeth Salguero, are you gonna stay for the 10 minutes today? Ellie? Elizabeth Salguero, are you there? I don't know. Well, I'm gonna stay, guys. I guess Elizabeth Salguero is staying for 10 minutes. If not, anybody can like stay and we can talk for 10 minutes or if you have any questions, all right? So thank you so much. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Have a great night.
You too.
Bye.
Good night.
Bye.
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 Bye. Take care.
Bye, good night. Bye.
Hi, Ellie. Hi, Ellie. Hi, Ellie. Ellie, can you hear me? Elizabeth. Hi, Ellie. Elizabeth, can you hear me? Ellie, can you hear me?